every year Ganesh Chaturthi comes just when the rains are waning, and clay images are made of Ganesha, and he's worshipped, he's welcomed, offerings are made to him, and after the worship is over, his image is dissolved in water. And we expect it to dissolve unless you're using plaster of Paris. Please don't use it. Please use clay. So year after year, he comes and goes. And I think this is to remind us that nothing in life is permanent. Life comes, life goes. Good things come, good things go. Bad things come, bad things go. And I think that's what Ganesha represents. His huge pot belly reminds us of affluence, of wealth. Remember, these images were done in time when food was in short supply. It's not like today when we are living with lots of agriculture, land, food. So this was abundance. It's called a Yakshamurti. And of course, nowadays we are doing six-pack Ganeshas, which means we don't like affluence anymore. And one has to think about it carefully, because that is the symbol of prosperity. It is replicated in the Modak. The Modak is like a bag of gold coins. If you see a bag of gold coins, it looks exactly like a Modak. But gold can bring unhappiness. Modak is made of sweets. So a traditional modak is contains sweet fillings to remind that wealth has to bring happiness. Ganesha's head, which is made of an elephant, reminds us of power, prosperity. See, elephant has no natural predator, so it can go anywhere, nothing can come in its way. So we want our lives to be like that, no predators, no threats, and we can go anywhere, wherever we want. And finally, the symbol of problems, the rat. The rat represents the problems. Even the greatest king, greatest warrior is unable to solve the problem of rats. Ganesha keeps him under control. And you pray to Ganesha so that the rats are not there, the wealth is flowing in with joy, prosperity, no predators, in a world that is cyclical.